Hi. We have a very exciting video for you today. It's the ultimate guide on how to set up profiles in Zoho SalesIQ. Subscribe to our channel to follow all the upcoming Zoho SalesIQ videos we have in store for you.
Hi, in this video, I will show you how you can set up or edit your profile in Zoho SalesIQ. For doing this, click on the Settings button in the top right corner and then go to My Profile under General tab. After that, you will be redirected to the My Profile section. And here you can change your photo or you can track your information about your name, your role, your status, and the departments to which you are associated, along with the time settings which are set per your profile. But if you want to edit some information, click on the Settings button in the top right corner, and then you will be redirected to the Setup page. On this page, you can set some information per sections. In the Personal Information section, you can set the first name, last name, or update it. You can set your known as name and date of birth by clicking on the calendar icon, and then you can choose the selected data. In the About You section, you can specify some information about you and you can write something about you. You can also track the departments to which you are associated. And the Concurrent Chat Limit section is this is the important setting. And here you can set the number of chats which you can handle simultaneously. What does this mean? So if you are the beginner and you can handle only 3 chats simultaneously, so here you can set only 3 chats limit. But if you are the senior support operator, then you can increase this limit to 10, 25, or you can set no limit at all. After that, you can also choose the font size you'd like, and you can specify your locale information. You can choose the language, and this is the searchable field. Also, you can specify your time zone, and this is the searchable field also. And you have the ability to choose the time format from 2 options, 12 hours or 24 hours. You can also specify the font and the communication details, like your email, mobile, phone, Twitter or LinkedIn, and some address details. Then the Visitor Engagement Permission section is also an important one. Here, if you are the support operator or some user or operator which will engage with visitors live, via live chat or via call, then this Visitor Engagement section should be enabled. And such permissions should be enabled. But if you're in the internal team and you don't need to engage with visitors at all, then this permission can be disabled. There is also the possibility to choose among 2 chat layouts, classic layout and modern layout. And the last 2 sections are the notification section setup. Here you can receive the mobile notifications when new visitor hits the site or some recurrent visitor hits the site. Or you can also enable the desktop notification and you will receive this desktop notification on your browser. Thank you.
Pretty exciting, right? We hope that was helpful. What other videos would you like us to record? Let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and share this video to people you know. Do you have questions or clarifications? Send them our way at know-how@customerization.ca.